Hello there, my name is Dave and I make videos on simplifying programming concepts. Today, let's talk about exponential backoff. In order to appreciate what exponential backoff really is and what it does, let's think of a couple of scenarios. Maybe you've written an SDK in the past that interacts with an API, and every now and then you get a bunch of transient errors and you're not sure what's happening. Maybe you'll write mobile apps that interact with backend APIs, whether internal or external, and every now and then you also get this sort of transient errors and you're not sure what's happening. Maybe you have attempted retrying upon failures, but you haven't seen much success. Those transient errors persist, and now you're not sure what's happening and you're thinking of switching careers to potato farming. Here's our very elegantly drawn depiction of a server, and even better and even more elegantly drawn depiction of clients. And all of those clients in a typical environment would be sent a request. And the problem here is computation resources are, like everything else in the world, finite. So given enough number of simultaneous request, the computational resources at the server would be depleted, and let it be CPU, memory, network, at a point, it would be just exhausted and out of resources. And in that situation, the server will start returning errors to the clients. In the vanilla situation, what happens if the client receives an error? It will start requesting the same request again, immediately, right away. Same for this client, same for this client. And as you can imagine, if all the clients are trying to get a service all the time from a busy server, they will get errors all the time. And yes, there is a slim chance that one of them will get the request fulfilled, but as you can see, it's not good for the overall system health. This kind of immediate attempts is called aggressive retry. Sometimes it's called immediate retry. This situation is called contention. And contention is where multiple entities are trying to access a shared resource. And in this situation, we need to do some resource management. Okay, so how can we do better? A better strategy than the vanilla strategy that we mentioned is what's so-called exponential backoff. And it's a method that's used in computer networks to avoid or try to combat the contention scenarios. And instead of doing aggressive or immediate retries, each client starts by a waiting period. Let's assume that a client sends a request, it doesn't work, then the client waits for 1 second. It doesn't succeed, it tries after 2 seconds. And it doesn't succeed, it tries after 4 seconds, 8 seconds, 16 seconds. And that keeps happening until either the request succeeds or a hard time out is reached. Let's get back to our super elegant drawing of a server and a bunch of clients. Here again, the clients send requests, but here with the exponential backoff strategy, instead of doing aggressive retries, the client starts doing spaced attempts. Let's assume that client 2 out of many clients sends a request and the server is busy because it's out of capacity. Whatever is going on, it responds with an error code. And then C2 could think, oh, that's a transient error. So instead of retrying right away, I will wait for 1 second. And then I try again, but still gets an error because the server doesn't have enough resources. Then after 2 seconds, it tries again, still error. Then it tries after 4 seconds, 8 seconds. And normally in a situation like this, you want to put some sort of a hard timeout. But in this fashion, what we are aiming to do is giving the server enough time to recover. You might think, oh, but I can imagine if I have a timeline like this, and let's say this is every second, and given a sufficient number of clients who do requests, we'll have some sort of buckets of requests. At a point, there will be clients trying to send the request, and then they fail at second one, and at second two, the same bunch of clients try again, and then at the fourth, it's almost the same problem, right? So intuitively, you could think that, yes, indeed, we got some advantage deploying exponential backoff, but there is still something missing, right? We still have those clusters of calls. And there is fortunately a way to mitigate this, which is called jitter.
Jitter is simply randomness incorporated into the delay between retries. Think of it that way. This is the timeline. And with the exponential backoff, we retry after 1 second, then after 2 seconds, and then after 4 seconds, then after 8 seconds, and so forth. But with jitter, instead of retrying after 1 or 2 or 4 or 8 seconds exactly, we add some randomness. There are two kinds of jitter. One of them is called full jitter, and the other one is called decorrelated jitter. For the full jitter, we calculate a random value, which is between 0 and the wait time. And the wait time, as we mentioned before, is 1 or 2 or 4 or 8 or 16. So let's say we are starting our attempts by waiting for 1 second. So we substitute this one here. And then this value could be 0, 0.01, 0.02, and so forth. And then this random value is subtracted from the wait time. And then we will end up with waiting either for a whole 1 second, or we retry right away. Assuming that the request fails, we retry again, and this time we calculate a new random value between 0 and the wait time, which is 2 seconds. It could be 1.1 and so forth. And then we subtract this value from 2. So it could be somewhere between here or here. And we keep trying until either the request succeeds or a hard time out is reached. For the equal or decorrelated jitter, we do the same by calculating a random value between 0 and the wait time. The difference is either we add this random value to the wait time or we subtract it, 0.02 seconds. Then we either add it to the wait time, which so it would be 1.2 seconds or 0.8 seconds. And then we track the request. Assuming that the request fails, we try again. We calculate a new random value between 0 and the wait time, which is this time 2 seconds. So it will be somewhere between 0 and 2, and let's say it generated 1.1. And then we either add it or subtract it from 2. So it could be 3.1 seconds or it could be 0.9 seconds. And we keep doing that until either the request succeeds or a hard time out is reached. Now you might be wondering what kind of jitter you are supposed to use. In reality, it doesn't matter. Both are effective strategies. In theory, the decorrelated jitter is more suitable for situations or scenarios where you need to retry very fast or you have very specific traffic patterns, like every 1 hour or so, where the full jitter is more suitable for situations with higher degrees of contention. You can see that there are a couple of aspects that got improved with this strategy. First of all, we avoided overloading the system. So in a scenario when the network is already overloaded, and instead of sending more requests and hence exacerbating the problem, you give the system the ability to handle more clients and hence even improved scalability. Another improved point with the exponential backoff with the jitter is fairness. So instead of a couple of very aggressive clients hoarding all the resources, all the clients are more or less treated the same. The system's efficiency increased because the system is now able to use its resources more efficiently rather than dealing constantly with retries and contention. For all of you out there who are into reading, the AWS blog has a de facto blog post on how exponential backoff works and the different strategies and the impact of those. And I will add a link in the description. That was it. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions or feedback or suggestions, please leave them in the comments below. And see you in the next one.